మా ఛానల్లోని అప్డేట్స్ మరియు నోటిఫికేషన్స్ కొరకు సబ్స్క్రైబ్ చేయండి. అలాగే పక్కనున్న బెల్ ఐకాన్ని టంగ్ని కొట్టండి.
Hi viewers, welcome back to your favorite YouTube channel, English with Jagadish. This is Jagadish Jakampudi, facilitator of English language. Dear teachers and children, in the previous class, we discussed reading segment A of A reading, Attitude is Altitude, from the theme, Personality Development. In today's class, we are going to continue with the reading segment 2. Before going to reading segment 2, let's recapitulate the things that we have discussed in the previous class. Dear teachers and children, in the previous class, we had discussed a few biographical details of Nick Vujicic. Through our discussion, we understood that Nick was born as a torso in Melbourne, Australia. Though he was born as a torso, he wanted to become independent, taking inspiration from several things. He did not get arms and legs, but in spite of that fact, he wanted to do several things which the normal people can do. That shows his positive attitude. Not only Nick, even his parents tried to help him since his childhood. They took so many extraordinary decisions to make him independent. The best decision for that was they had sent him to a mainstream school instead of sending him to the special school. In a special school, special children would be educated. Since Nick was born without arms and legs, he could have been sent to that special school. But instead of sending him to that special school, they have sent him to the mainstream school just to make him to face all the difficulties that he would possibly face in the future. If he faces all those challenges right now, he can become independent. He can face the challenges that would come in the future with a lot of confidence and with a lot of perseverance. So with that hope, they had sent him to the mainstream school just to make him independent. Not only these things, certain other characteristics of Nick also we have discussed. The important among them was that Nick was an evangelical Christian. Because of that belief, he remained a virgin until his marriage. With a lot of hard work and perseverance, he became a symbol of triumph over adversities at the end. After becoming successful, many girls came forward with the proposal of marrying him. But Nick did not accept all the proposals. He had an opinion that he should not marry the girl who was beautiful. His point was that he should marry a girl who could understand him, who could love him, and who could live with him comfortably. So that's why he waited for the right girl to come along. Finally, he chose a right girl and married. That was a different story. And some other things also we are going to discuss today in today's class. We are going to see the other challenges or humiliations Nick had faced when he was growing up or when he was in the schooling. We are also going to see how Nick had faced all those things with a lot of confidence, with a lot of hard work, with a lot of perseverance. We have to get so much of inspiration from Nick's life. So let us have a look at the other incidents that have happened in the life of Nick. So to discuss all those things, let me share a few slides from the text.
Yes.
Okay. Welcome back to the session. As I have already told you, it is reading A, Attitude is Altitude, in theme number 1, Personality Development. So let's go on with segment 2 of Attitude is Altitude. So let's continue our reading session. An extract from the text, Attitude is Altitude. Let's continue the reading. His disability came without any medical explanation, a rare occurrence called phocomelia. And Nick and his parents spent many years asking why this cruel trick would happen to them. My mother was a nurse and she did everything right during pregnancy, but she still blamed herself, he said. Let's understand this paragraph, dear children and teachers. Before discussing this paragraph, let's have a look at these highlighted words. Disability. Disability is a physical condition that stops a person's movements. Phocomelia, it's a disease. If this disease attacks, the children do not form their limbs to their full size. So it is nothing but extreme disorder due to malformation of limbs. And finally, cruel trick. Here, the cruel trick refers to very sad thing happened by fate. Dear teachers and children, in the previous class, we discussed that Nick was born as a torso. Because of that torso, he could not move, he could not do anything. See, this is what a torso is. No arms, no legs. So, what is it? Malformation of limbs. Malformation means they do not grow to their full size. Certain limbs will form, but they do not grow to their full size. Because of that malformation, only we can see the short or small foot here. We don't see total hands here, but only one small foot has formed here, but that did not grow to its full size. When Nick was born, he looked like this. You see, this disability came without any medical explanation. When Nick was born, Nick's parents had taken him to several hospitals, approached several doctors, but the doctors and the hospitals did not have any explanation for that one. For other diseases, the doctors say the reasons for that disease. But even today, people do not say, or the doctors cannot say, the reasons for this disease, phocomelia. If this disease attacks, children take birth without arms and legs. If at all the arms and legs are formed, they do not grow to their full size. So even the doctors could not give the reasons for this phocomelia. You see, Nick and his parents asked many people why that cruel trick had happened to them. So here, the cruel trick refers to the sad thing happened to Nick. They met several people and asked why that condition happened to their baby. But nobody had an answer for that one. And nothing was wrong from mother's side also. When she was pregnant, being a nurse, Nick's mother took every care. She took medicines regularly. She took the diet properly. Everything was all right. But in spite of doing all these things, though she had done everything, Nick's mother blamed herself. Nick's mother blamed herself. Why do you think that Nick's mother blamed herself? The reasons, possibly, maybe that since Nick came from her womb, she blamed herself. He did not come from the air. Nick came from his mother's womb. That's why Nick's mother always blamed herself for giving such a deformed baby. Let's continue with one more slide. It was so hard for them, but right from the start, they did their best to make me independent. My dad put me in the water at 18 months and gave the courage to learn how to swim. I also got really into football and skateboarding. I really love the English Premier League. So let's see the highlighted word here, courage. What do you mean by courage? A quality of being confident. See, anyway, Nick was born as a torso. The doctors had no explanation for that one. Even the medical department could not explain to Nick's parents why that cruel trick had happened to their baby. As it had happened, Nick's parents accepted it. And soon after accepting it, they tried to make Nick independent. For that one, they started doing several things. Though certain things were very difficult, though certain things were very hard for them to do, they went on doing. It was so hard for them, but right from the start, they did their best to make me independent. Here, them refers to Nick's parents. Though making Nick independent was very difficult, they did their best. Whatever they could do, they did. They had taken almost all the steps they had to take to make Nick independent. So let us see what were the things they had taken to make Nick independent. What were the things that made Nick independent? What were the things that became very difficult for them to make Nick independent? The first thing you see, in order to make Nick independent, or in order to make Nick to live on his own legs, they wanted to give him courage first. For that one, his father had taken a beautiful decision or an extreme decision. Let us look at that decision. My dad put me in the water at 18 months and gave me the courage to learn how to swim. I also got really into football and skateboarding. I totally love the English Premier League. You see, no father can take such a decision when Nick was just 18 months old. That means when he was just 1.5 years old, Nick's father had put Nick in water in order to make him learn swimming. Can any father do that, that thing? Can any father take that decision? It is highly impossible, highly dangerous also. Though that was very dangerous, though that was a very hard thing to put him in the water, Nick's father had taken that decision in order to give him that courage, the quality of being confident. Confident or courage refers to dhairyam. Just to give him that courage, Nick's parents had put him in the water. When he was in the water, he had faced so many problems. So just to come out of that water, just to live, to survive, Nick had got some courage. Just to give that courage, Nick's father had put him in water when Nick was just 18 months old. What a brave decision it was. Not only that, because of all those things, and sky was the limit for Nick's ambition. He wanted to learn football and skateboarding. You see, this is called skateboarding. And see, here Nick was playing football. See, sky was the limit. Though he did not have arms or legs, he wanted to learn all the things which we can do. Those people who have arms and legs can do several things. But Nick can't. Though it is very difficult for him, he wanted to learn all those things like going on skateboard, like playing football, all these things. He is a huge fan of English Premier League. It is English Premier League is nothing but a football match. He loves it. So this is about this extract. Let's go on with another extract. Let's continue. Nick's father was a computer programmer and accountant, and he taught his little son how to type with his toe at just 6 years old. His mom invented a special plastic device that meant he could hold a pen and a pencil. Despite the risk of being bullied, his parents insisted Nick on attending mainstream school. It was the best decision they could have made for me, adds Nick, who later achieved a degree in financial planning and real estate. It was very hard, but it gave me independence. Let us see some other things Nick's parents had done for Nick to make him independent. See, as a profession, Nick's father was a computer programmer and accountant. It was his profession. And as he was a computer programmer, he taught his little son. Here is the little son refers to Nick. He taught Nick how to type with his toe at just 6 years old. See, when Nick was 18 months old, his father tried to make him learn swimming. When Nick grew six years old, Nick's father tried to make him learn typing using his toes. Here you can see Nick was typing using his toes here. If the fingers on the hand, and we say fingers on the hand, we say toes on the leg. Chetu paina unte vellu, kalukunte toes, we say. See, fingers, toes, right? So despite the risk of being bullied, his parents insisted Nick on attending mainstream school. One more beautiful decision. See, first thing, one thing had already happened. When Nick was just 18 months old, his father had put him in the water just to make him learn swimming. And when Nick was 6 years old, his father tried to make him type the things using his toes. Not only his father, even his mother had also done some amazing things. His mom invented a plastic device that could hold a pen or pencil. Here you see a plastic device was attached to his toes. Using that device, he could hold a pen or pencil. Plastic device here is useful for holding the pen or pencil. If that plastic device is set to that small foot, no, with the help of that plastic device, he could write using a pen. And not only that, one more thing also they had done for Nick. That was they wanted to put him in the mainstream school. Mainstream school means the general school or common school that the common children go. You children generally go to the mainstream school. Here all types of children come to the school. But the other schools are also there. Instead of mainstream school, for those children who have got special needs, they are sent to these special schools. Since Nick is a TASO, he should be sent to a special school. There, the special teachers will be there to train him. But instead of sending him to that special school, Nick's parents had decided to send him this mainstream school just to give him courage or just give him the confidence to make the problems that he would possibly face in the future. But you see, if he is sent to that mainstream school now, there will be some bullyings. Bullying is nothing but frightening. Some children will come and tease him because of his appearance. Nick's parents knew it very well. Though they knew that Nick would be bullied in the school, though they knew that Nick would face so many challenges or difficulties or humiliations in the school, they decided to send him to this mainstream school. See here, all the other children are healthy except Nick here. But the children possibly may tease him because of his appearance. Nick's parents knew it very well. But just to make him independent, Nick's parents had taken a decision of sending him to this mainstream school only. As per their decision, as they have expected, Nick had faced so many humiliations and challenges in that mainstream school. After facing those challenges or humiliations only, Nick became very confident. Nick got that courage to face all the things that he should possibly face in the future. It was the best decision they could have made for me, adds Nick. What does it refers to here? It is that is nothing but sending him to the mainstream school. Nick's parents decided to send him to that mainstream school. Because of that decision, he had faced so many challenges. Because of that decision only, he became independent. Because he had faced so many humiliations there, he had faced so many difficulties there. When he was facing all those humiliations or challenges, Nick also learned how to face all those difficulties or how to cope up with all those humiliations. Finally, he became independent in that mainstream school itself. Instead, Nick, one grammar point is there here. You see, these parents insisted Nick on attending mainstream school. Insist is generally followed by the preposition on. Insist on, we say. Nick's parents insisted Nick on attending mainstream school. In the beginning, Nick was not happy to go to that mainstream school. He was so sad because he too knew that he would face so many problems there. That's why Nick rejected to go to that mainstream school. But Nick's parents insisted on attending the mainstream school. It was the best decision they could have made for me. See, later Nick realized that was the best decision they had taken for him. Because of that decision only, he became very confident. He became independent. Later, after studying in that mainstream school, he continued his studies. He achieved a degree in financial planning and real estate. Financial planning and real estate, it was very hard, but it gave me independence. So acquiring that degree in financial planning and real estate was very difficult. He had faced so many problems there. Though it was very hard, it gave him independence. This financial planning and real estate refers to the act of selling and buying land and getting commission, all those things. So Nick got a degree in this subject. What is the Nick degree Nick possessed now? Financial planning and real estate. So here you see, impossible is nothing. With a lot of confidence, lot of perseverance, lot of hard work, he achieved impossible things. Let's continue with one more slide. Nick, who was teased and bullied, had an electric wheelchair for mobility and a team of carers to help him. I was deeply depressed when I was 8 years old, he said. I went to my mom crying and told her I wanted to kill myself. I felt cold and bitter. I hated God for doing this to me and was terrified of what would happen when my parents were not there to look after me. Let's take a look at these highlighted words. Tease. What do you mean by tease? Provoke or make angry. Next, mobility. The act of movement is called mobility. depressed. What do you mean by depressed? Feel very sad or unhappy. And look after, one more phrasal verb is there here. Look after means take care of. Now let's try to comprehend this paragraph here. Nick was teased and bullied, had an electric wheelchair for mobility and a team of carers to help him. Dear teachers and children, as we have already discussed, Nick was teased in the school. When he went to the mainstream school, several children teased him because of his appearance. He was bullied. He was humiliated. He was frightened. But not only that, how did Nick go to school and how did he study there? With the help of an electric wheelchair, you see here. Since Nick has no arms and legs, no, he uses this electric wheelchair. Using this electric wheelchair, he moves from one place to other place. With the help of this electric wheelchair, he used to go to that mainstream school. And not only that, not only the assistance of electric wheelchair, even Nick had a team of carers who could help him. Nick, there were some people to help Nick in the school also. So with the help of this electric wheelchair, with a team of carers, he attended the mainstream school. But when he went to that mainstream school, he faced so many humiliations. He faced so much of teasing there. Because of that one, Nick says, I was deeply depressed. Because of that humiliations, because of the difficulties he had faced in that mainstream school, he was so much depressed. He felt sad. He felt that his life was very, very unhappy. And these things happened to Nick when he was 8 years old. I went to my mom crying and told her I wanted to kill myself. See the pessimistic attitude of Nick in the beginning. He was so depressed that he wanted to kill himself. What a sad thing it is. That's why one day he came home from school and met his mother, told her that he wanted to kill himself. Why did he want to kill himself? Because of this depression, because of the teasings he had faced in the school, because of the bullyings he had faced in the school. Everything appeared so sad. Everything appeared dark because of that depression, as he had to depend on others for everything, as everyone was teasing him, as everyone was humiliating him, as he could not do anything, as he was depending on others for everything, he was so depressed. That's why he had taken that extreme decision of killing himself. But you see, children, Nick was just 8 years old by then. At the age of 8 years old, he got those pessimistic thoughts. It is quite uncommon, but it had happened to Nick. Because of that depression, he thought of killing himself and told his mother. See, I felt cold and bitter. This is the sentence you have to understand here. Felt cold and bitter means feel cold and bitter, refers to hopelessness. Nick felt that life was cold. Cold does not refer to the cold of the general cold. It is helplessness, hopelessness, or inability, bitter, sad. So here, cold and bitter refers to helplessness or a feeling of depression or sadness, lack of hope. Since he was depending on others, since he was being humiliated by others, since he was bullied for everything, since he was teased for everything, since he was depending on others for everything, he felt cold and bitter. Life became cold and bitter for him. Nirasha janakanga maripoyindi. He wanted to kill himself because of that depression. He wanted to kill himself and he told his mother that he would kill himself. You see, the depression went to such an extent that he hated God for doing this to me. Doing this. What do you mean by doing this? Making him a torso. Making him a torso. Try to understand this sentence. Such a question. So in the exam, you are generally asked to explain these tricky expressions. What do you mean by doing this here? That is nothing but making Nick a torso. Whom do you think that made Nick a torso? Probably Nick thought that it was God. That's why he started hating God. See, at the age of 8 years old, he got all those pessimistic thoughts. He thought of killing himself. Even he started hating God for making him a torso. And not only that, he looked further and terrified of what would happen when my parents were his parents were not there to look after him. Nick thought about his future. He thought that after his parents' death, there would be nobody to look after him, to take care of him. See, at that time, Nick had his parents. They were taking care of him. They were giving him food. They were helping him for everything. But Nick looked into the future and felt that there would be no person to support him. Nick understood that in the future, he would face so many other challenges. With that thought, he wanted to kill himself. So in this paragraph, we see the negative side of Nick. See, but this negative side did not last long. He did not continue with this negative thoughts for a long time. For a time being, he was so sad because of the things happened in his school or around him. Particularly because of this teasing and bullying, as he was depending on others for everything, as he felt that his life was cold and bitter, as he felt that there would be no person to support him in the future, he was so depressed. Out of that depression means nirasha, out of that depression, noun form, nirashalo, he wanted to kill himself. Tannu thane champesukovalanukunnadu. Very, very unfortunate decision in the beginning, but he came out of that depression very soon. Let's continue with the other extract. You see here, I could brush my own teeth with a wall-mounted brush and wash my own hair with a pump-action soap. But there was so much that was impossible for me. At age 10, Nick tried to drown himself in the bath, but luckily the attempt was unsuccessful. I felt there was no purpose when you lack purpose and strength. It is so hard to hold on, he said. But with the help of his religion, friends, and family, Nick managed to pull through to become an international symbol of triumph over adversity. Let us have a look at these highlighted words here. A wall-mounted. What do you mean by wall-mounted? Attached to wall. Unsuccessful. What do you mean by unsuccessful? Failure. What I mean? Pull through to come out. Bite kuch chese item. Triumph. What is triumph? Success. Vijayam. Adversity. What is adversity? Extreme difficulty. Chala kastamaina badha kalginche. Let's try to comprehend this paragraph here. In this paragraph, we are going to see some other pessimistic thoughts of Nick Vujicic. Some other the negative side of Nick. I could brush my own teeth with a wall-mounted brush and wash my own hair with a pump-action soap. See, with the wall-mounted brush, he could brush his own teeth. That is okay. In the morning, soon after waking up, he brushes his teeth with the support of a wall-mounted brush. The brush has been fixed to the wall. With the support of that brush, he could brush his own teeth. And even he could take bath because of that pump-action soap. Parents invented these things or brought those things for Nick. One thing was wall-mounted brush. It was because of his parents. And one more thing was also there for taking bath, a pump-action soap. Just using that pump-action soap, automatically gets water and he could take bath also. He could brush, he could take bath. With these two things, can we survive? Is it possible? There are several other things you have to do soon after waking up. You have to do so many things. So, see, but there was so much that was impossible for me. Not only these two things, he had to do so many other things. See, one more pessimistic thing happened or negative thing happened in Nick's life. At age 10, Nick tried to drown himself in the bath, but luckily the attempt was unsuccessful. At age 8, he got the idea of killing himself. But at age 10, he executed that thought. What was that thought? Killing himself. Attempt to kill himself or suicide. At age 10, he tried to kill himself by drowning in the bathtub. But fortunately, the attempt was unsuccessful. Someone might have noticed it and saved Nick. I felt there was no purpose when you lack purpose and strength. See, these are the negative feelings of Nick. Because of the humiliations, because of the difficulties he was facing throughout his life, he got so many sad thoughts. I felt there was no purpose when you lack purpose and strength. So Nick could not see any positive thing for him. He could not see any hope for him. So you see, I felt there was no purpose. Why should I live? What am I going to do? What is my life for? How many days should I live like this? What is the purpose of my life? I have been depending on others for everything. What should I do now? That was his thought. When you lack purpose and strength, if you have no purpose and strength, what is your life? One should be independent. One should live happily. If you don't have that independence, if you depend on others for everything, if you always see the negative side of the things, if the life looks very dark, if your life seems to be unhappy, you too generally get those negative thoughts. In the same way, Nick too got the same pessimistic thoughts. Nick was going on seeing the negative side of the things, so that Nick felt that he had no purpose to live. He was depending on others for everything. That's why he wanted to kill himself and try to drown himself in the water. But luckily, that attempt was unsuccessful. Atmahatya chesukundam annatuvanti nirnayam adrushtavashattu aa nirnayam nunchi bayatapaddadu, tanu chanipokunda bayatapaddadu. But with the help of his religion, friends and family, Nick managed to pull through to become an international symbol of triumph over adversity. See, to come out of those depressed feelings, his parents had helped him a lot, his religion had helped him a lot, and even his friends had helped him a lot. In the beginning, he was so depressed, he wanted to kill himself, but with the support of his religion, Christianity, or with the support of his parents, even with the support of his friends, he could pull through, come out of that depression. And he came out of that depression and finally became successful. Not only successful, he became a symbol of triumph. Symbol of triumph. What do you mean by triumph? Success. Vijayaniki gurtuga migilipoyadu. Kashtalanu edurukoni vijayam sadhinchina vyakti evaranna ee prapanchamlo unnadu ante adi Nick ani maatladukune vidhanga Nick tayarayadu. What a life it is. Let's continue. When I was 13, I read a newspaper article about a disabled man who had managed to achieve great things and helped others, said Nick. I realized why God had made us like this, to give hope to others. It was so inspirational to me that I decided to use my life to encourage other people and give them the courage that the article had given me. Let's look at the highlighted word here. Encourage. Encourage is nothing but motivate. So let's discuss this paragraph. When I was 13, see, when Nick was 18 years old, he got the idea of killing himself. When he was 10 years old, he tried to kill himself by drowning in the water. The depressed thoughts continued until 13 years old. When Nick was 13 years old, he read a newspaper article about a disabled man doing great things. When I was 13, I read a newspaper article about a disabled man who had managed to achieve great things and helped others, said Nick. After reading this newspaper article, he read about a person who was doing great things, though he was physically challenged. After, what was the age of Nick at that time? He was just 13 years old. After reading that article, he understood that, he realized that God had made him like this. Like this refers to a torso. He understood that God had made him a torso just to give hope to others. After reading this newspaper article, he realized it. He understood that a person is born not to kill himself, just to give hope to others. Particularly, a disabled man is born to give hope to others who are suffering like him. So, after reading this newspaper article, he understood that, because in this newspaper article, that man who was said to be a physically challenged one was living happily and helping others. After reading this newspaper article, Nick too understood that, why couldn't I live like him? As he was living independently, though he was a physically challenged person, being a physically challenged person, that person was helping others. Why couldn't I do like this? That was his realization. And he understood that in the beginning, he hated God. That same Nick started appreciating God, saying that God had given him that life. to give hope to others. It was so inspirational. The news, what is it here? The newspaper article. It was so inspirational, and he decided to use his life to encourage other people and give them the courage that the article had given him. The article had given him so much of courage. The article had given him so much of confidence. It totally changed his way of looking at the things. And with that inspiration, with that courage, with that confidence, he wanted to live independently. Not only he wanted to live independently, but also he wanted to help others who were suffering like him. That is the change of attitude that had happened in Nick's life when he was 13 years old. So that newspaper article had totally changed the way of perception of Nick's thinking. He had understood that he had to live happily. He should not feel sad for the things that happened to him. He felt in the beginning that Nick had, God had made him a torso to suffer. But the same Nick, after reading this newspaper article, understood that or realized that God had given him a boon, varam ichadu devunaku, to give hope to others. I should live independently, I should live happily, and I should help others who are suffering like me. That was the change in the attitude of Nick. So that's all. Thank you here. So that's all for today from my side. Dear teachers and children, in the next class, we are going to see some other things of Nick's life. Thank you. We'll end the session here.